Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel, Civil Engineering Tutorial by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates.
In this video lecture, I will explain you analysis and designing of composite column building by using ETABS software. So composite column is nothing but the combination of two materials like steel as well as RCC member. In this tutorial, I will consider a rectangular section. In that rectangular section, I will insert steel member of I section. Go to ETABS software, select ETABS software. So the software will be open like this. So initially we need to cancel this. So we need to change the units from kip inches to kilonewton meter initially. So for that, select your units as kilonewton meter. So after that, click on file model, click on new model. So here we need to select model type as no. So it will open like this. So it will be consisting of grid dimension, nothing but plan dimensions, as well as story dimensions, nothing but number of floors. So here we need to enter the number of lines in x direction, number of lines in y direction, spacing, default spacing in x direction, default spacing in y direction. So here we need to enter the number of stories, so typical story height as well as bottom story height. So in this section, in this building, just I am considering number of lines in x direction are 6, number of lines in y direction are 5. So default spacing I am considering in x direction are 3 and in spacing in y direction are 3. So here we need to consider this simple story data. So just I'm considering G plus 6 story building, nothing but 7 slabs. So each slab will be consisting of 3 meter for respected typical story height and bottom story height. So after that, click on grid only button. So after that, click on OK. So it will open the grids like this. So left hand section will be consisting of plan dimensions, as well as right hand section will be consisting of 3D view for the respected grids. So initially we need to select the IS code for before assigning being column section. So for that, go to options button, click on preference. So here we need to select the concrete frame design. In concrete frame design, we need to change the ACI code to IS code. Here we need to select IS 456-2000 code. Next, I'm selecting IS 456-2000. So after that, click on OK button. So after that, go to options again for changing the steel section code. So click on preference. So here we need to select the steel frame design. Here we need to change AISC code to Indian code, Indian IS 800-1998 code. Click on OK button. So after that, we need to define the material properties. Material properties is nothing but grade of concrete as well as grade of steel for the respected building. So I'm defining the material properties. Click on define matter, click on material properties. The material will be consisting of concrete, other steel. So in that, we need to select the concrete section for addition of RCC column. So click on add new material. So here we need to enter the material type. Just I'm entering the material type as M30 as the name. So here we need to change the design property data as per Indian standard IS 456-2000 code. So here we need to enter the FCK. FCK is nothing but cube compressive strength value. So here we need to enter FCK value as 30,000. Nothing but M30 grade concrete as per assumption. So here we need to enter the steel section. So just I am taking the steel section is 550 grade steel. Just after that, we need to add shear reinforcement also. Just I am entering 550 again for the shear reinforcement. Click on OK. So here I was defined the respected M30 grade for this G plus 6 building. So after that, we need to define the beam columns as well as slab thickness for the respected building. So for that, go to define button. Here we need to click on frame sections. So initially we need to delete all previous sections, default section for the respected building. Just I'm selecting all my previous sections. So after that, click on delete property. So here we need to add the rectangular section for this respected building for assigning of beam. So for that, go to add, click on add rectangular section. Just I'm taking the beam. Just I'm assuming the size as 0.4 × 0.4. So after that, we need to change the material type from steel to M30 grade. So here I am taking the depth as 0.4 and width is also 0.4. So here we need to select the reinforcement type. Next, I am selecting reinforcement. So after that, here we need to select the beam design type. So here we need to take the top and bottom reinforcement cover as 0.06, nothing but 10% of the dimensions of respected beam. So click on OK button. So click on OK. So just here we need to create the composite column. So as I told earlier, so composite column is nothing but the combination of steel member as well as RCC member. So for addition of composite column, here we need to select add SD sections. So in that SD sections, we need to select the section name. This time assuming the section name is composite column CC. So here we need to click on section designer. So it will open the respective section designer in ETABS software. So here we need to add the rectangular section of 0.5 by 0.5 and I section also. So initially I will add I section for this respected column. So for that go to draw option. Here we need to select the draw structural shape. Just click on I wide flange. Just I am assigning wide flange section here like this. So this is my I section. So select your respected I section, right click on it. So it will be consisting of height as 0.5, top width as 0.5, top thickness as 0.05, web thickness as 0.05, bottom width as 0.5 and bottom thickness as 0.05. Just I am changing the respected height as 0.5 to 0.3. Again I am changing the top width as 0.5 to 0.3 same. So just I am taking top thickness as 0.03. Again I am changing the web thickness as 0.03 as same. So again I am changing the bottom width also 0.3 section. Again I am taking the bottom thickness as 0.03 section. So after that click on OK button. So it will change the dimensions from respected 0.5 section to 0.3 section. So after that we need to add a rectangular section for this respective I section. So for that go to click on draw button again. Again draw respected draw solid shapes. Click on rectangular shape. Just we need to pick a point inside this. So after that we need to select the respective rectangular portion. Just select your respective properties. So here property will be consisting of height as 0.5 by 0.5. So after that click on OK. So after that we need to cancel this respected structure SD. So after that it will assign the respected composite column of 0.5 by 0.5 to the SD section data. So after that click on OK. So it will create the respected CC, nothing but composite column, to the respected building. So after that click on OK button. So after that we need to define the slab thickness for the respected composite column building. So for that go to click on define button. Click on wall slab deck section. So here I am deleting default to slabs initially. Just I am selecting deck slab, delete, 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 delete. So after that select slab section. Just I am giving the slab name as S150 as the name. Just we need to select the material here. Just I am selecting material as M30 grade. So just I am changing 0.15 and 0.15 is the thickness for the respected membrane as well as bending thickness for the respected column. So after that we need to select the type as membrane section. Click on OK. It will generate the respected membrane section here. So after that select wall 1. Click on delete section. Click on OK. So after that we need to assign the beam section, column section and slab thickness for the respected G plus 6 building. So for assigning of beams and columns, initially we need to change one story data to all stories. So after that select the beam cursor. So here we need to select the property as B.4 by 0.4 section, nothing but beam. So drag to the respective plan section. It will assign the respected beam to the respective model in both plan view as well as 3D view. So after that we need to assign the column section. Further select column section. So we need to change the property from B.4 by 0.4 to CC, nothing but composite column. Drag to the respected plan. So it will assign the respected composite column. So it will be consisting of I section with the rectangular section, combination of your rectangular RCC section as well as I section for the respected beam for the respected building. So after that click on plan view. So after that we need to assign the slab for the respected building. Go to select the slab section. So here we need to select the property type as S150. So after that drag to the respected plan portion. Now the slab section is assigned for both plan view as well as 3D view, but it is not visible. For visibility of slab section, just we need to go to set building view option. Click on object fill. Click on apply to all windows. Click on OK. So it will visible to the respected beam, column as well as slab thickness for the respected building. So after that we need to delete all the beams as well as slab thickness at the base. So we need to initially select the respective bottom story. Further go to select option, select by story level, select base, click on select button. So click on delete button. So it will delete all the section at the base. So after that we need to assign the respective load cases for this building. So for this building, just I am assuming dead load as well as live load and floor load. So here we need to define the these three load cases initially. So for that, go to define button. So click on static load cases. The software will be defaultly define respected dead load as well as live load. So here we need to assign the respected floor load after this. So here we need to select the type as super dead. Select, after that click on add new node. So click on OK. So after that we need to assign the respected dead load, live load as well as floor load for the respective building. So initially we need to assign dead load. So in that dead load we need to assign the self weight of the structure as well as dead load of the beam, dead load of the column, dead load of the slab for this section. So for that, go to select all by using Ctrl A button for assigning of the self weight. Go to assign button, go to just select joint point load, click on forces. So here we need to select the dead load for the force in x direction as well as y direction as well as z direction, and moment in global xx, moment in yy, moment in zz as 111. Click on add to existing loads, click on OK. So it will assign the respected dead load for the respected building. So after that we need to assign the dead load of the beam. So here we need to calculate the dead load of the beam individually. So for calculating dead load of the beam, we need to take the dimensions of the respected beam as well as unit weight of the concrete. So just I am taking my dimensions of the beam is 0.4 cross 0.4 cross 25. So it is nothing but 4 kilonewton per meter. So we need to assign the dead load of the respective beam. For that, go to select option, go to select frame sections, nothing but beam sections or column section. Just I am selecting 0.4 by 0.4. Go to click on assign button, click on frame loads, click on distributed load. Here we need to click on add to existing loads. So after that we need to select the load case name as dead load. Here we need to enter the uniform load of 4 kilonewton per meter. Click on OK button. So it will assign the respected dead load to the respected building. So after that we need to assign the dead load of the column. So for that, go to select option, select by frame sections, select composite column CC. So CC is consisting of 0.5 by 0.5 is cross section. We need to multiply the respective 0.5 by 0.5 by 25. It is nothing but 6.25. We need to assign the respective 6.25 for the respected column. Go to assign option, frame line load, distributed load, add to existing loads. So here we need to change 6.25 as the dead load of the respected column. Click on add to existing loads, click on OK. So it will assign the respected dead load for the respected column. So after that we need to assign the dead load of the slab member. For that, go to select option, go to wall slab deck section. Just I am selecting slab S150. So here we need to calculate the slab dead load for the respected 150 mm thickness. Just I am taking 0.15 multiplied by 25, click on equal. So it will be consisting of 3.75. go to assign button, shell area load, uniform, add to existing loads. 3.75 is my dead load, nothing in gravity direction. Click on OK. So after that we need to assign the respected live load for the respected building. So further, go to select option again. I am selecting wall slab deck section, select S150. So after that click on assign button, shell area load, select uniform load. So here we need to change dead load to the respected live load. Click on add to existing load. So here I am assuming for the live load of 3 kilonewton per meter in gravity direction. Click on OK. So after that we need to assign the floor load. So for that, go to select wall slab deck section again. I am selecting S150, go to assign option, shell area load, uniform. Here we need to change the load case name from live load to floor load, add to existing loads. So here we need to change the load type 0.5, so in gravity direction. Click on OK. So here it will assign the respected live load and floor load for the respective building. So after that we need to assign the supports for this respective building. So further, go to select base initially, go to select option, click on story level, select base, click on OK. So it was selected all base. So after that, go to assign button, assign joint point. Here we need to select the restraints, nothing but supports in bracket. So select the fixed support, click on OK. So it will assign the fixed support at the base. So after that we need to apply the diaphragm for this respective building. So further, go to select all the building by using Ctrl A option, go to assign joint point, click on diaphragms, select D1, click on OK. So diaphragm is nothing but the center point of the respective building and load action rate for the respective building from the joint. So diaphragm was visible in plan section. For appearing of this diaphragm section at the 3D view, select your respective 3D view, go to select the right mark. So after that, select diaphragm extent, apply to all windows, click on OK. So it will apply the respective diaphragm section at the 3D view. So after that, we need to analyze this respected composite column building. So further go to analyze option, click on set analysis option. So click on select dynamic parameters. Just I'm selecting number of modes are 12 here, click on OK. So after that, click on OK button. So after that, analyze again, check models. Here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective model. Select first point, second point, third point, click on OK. So it will check the respected model. So it was checked with zero errors, no warnings. So after that, go to analyze option, click on run analysis. So here we need to save the respected model. Just I'm saving my respected model to the composite column building with name as AA. Click on save button. So it will starting analysis of the respective model. So analysis is completed for the respective model. So right side 3D view contain the deflection of the respective building. For seeing the deflection, we need to click on start animation button. So it will starts deflecting the building in 3D view. So this is the deflection of the respected building. So it will be deflecting this direction. So due to presence of the dead load case. So if you want to change this respective deflection of the shape due to presence of the live load case, we need to go to display option. Click on display deform shape. Here we need to change the dead load to live static. Click on OK button. So it will directly show this respected deflection in downward direction due to presence of the downward load, nothing but the live load for the respective building. So after that, we need to see the deflection values as well as shear values and bending values for this respected building. So further go to display option, click on show tables. So here we need to select the load cases initially. Just I'm selecting the load cases as dead load, live load as well as floor load. In this case, click on OK. So after that, select displacement values. So here we need to pick story drift value. So after that, say click on building output value. So here nothing but select story shear value, nothing but shear force and bending moment values. So after that, click on OK. So it will contain the respected deflection, nothing but story drift in X direction as well as Y direction for this respective building. So here deflection, nothing but drift X in both X direction as well as Y direction for the respected story and for the respected load case. So after that, select shear, story shear. So it will contain the lateral force P, VX, shear force in X direction, shear force in Y direction, MX, moment in X direction, moment in Y direction, building torsion T. So after that, we need to see the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for this respective model. So for that, go to display option, click on show member forces stress diagrams. So here we need to pick the frame pier spandrel forces. So here we need to select the axial force, nothing but P load, click on OK. So this is the axial force for this respective building. So after that, you go to display option, show deform shape again, go to display option, show member forces, spandrel forces. So here I am selecting moment 2 to nothing but bending moment in X direction. So this is the bending moment diagram for the respective building. So after that, go to display again, select spandrel forces, select shear 3T, shear force in Y direction, click on OK. So this is the shear force for the respective building. So after that, we need to design the respective building by using ETABS software. For that, go to click on design. So here we need to select the concrete design. So here we need to click on start design, check for structure. So it will check the respective design for the respective building. So it was designed with the white lines. So here we need to select any one of the beam, just right click on it. So it will contain overall view of the respective design, summary of the respective design values and calculation sheet. So it will be consisting of flexure details calculation sheet as well as shear details calculation sheet as per the grade of concrete and grade of steel. So click on envelope. So this is the envelope for this respective design for the respective column as well as beam. This is the process analysis and designing of composite column building by using Statro VATA software. Thank you.